Hi everyone, I'm Roy McConaughey. I'm a reader in international development here at the University of Bath in the United Kingdom. And I work within a group of scholars in the Center for Development Studies. We're an interdisciplinary group of scholars looking at development issues around the world.
Hi everybody, my name's Simon Wolf. I'm the in-house filmmaker here at the University of Bath. My job is to provide a filmmaking service to all the academics who are based here. It can be a wide range in subjects. And Roy and I worked together to produce the film Voices from the Mine.
I first started working in Sierra Leone about 15 years ago. 2003 was the first time I went to Kano District, where much of the film was shot. And the project that I was working on was looking at post-conflict reconstruction. As many of you know, there's been a lot of links that have been explored between artisanal diamond mining and the conflict itself. And I was very much interested in looking at rebuilding livelihoods in this area where there was a lot of damage done during the war. So the first work I was doing was looking at post-conflict reconstruction, but diamonds immediately became part of the equation in terms of how I saw that society should be rebuilt in Kano District. Simon and I have made three films together. This is our third project that we've worked on, and we've had quite a bit of success in taking my work and sharing it with a much wider audience through the medium of film. The people that we're working with in many of these communities are desperately poor, and the work goes far beyond just sort of academic issues. And we both feel that there's a need to take this work and share it with a wider audience. So film has been a brilliant way of translating that academic work into a medium that can be shared very widely.
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that we're really keen to have happen here at the university is for the research that goes on here to have actual impact. And film is a great way of getting research seen by a wide audience. So obviously we're here in the UK, in Bath, talking to you guys in Japan, which is testament to the fact of the power that the film can have. We're also in discussions to have it filmed, to have it screened at an event in Chicago. And in May this year, we actually traveled to the United Nations in New York as well to screen the film, which just goes to show how powerful it can be to take the research which experts like Roy have been working on for years, and to make that into a film which then, as I say, can reach audiences that otherwise would never get to see it.
In the film, one of the things that we've really tried to do is capture the different voices of all the different stakeholders in the artisanal diamond value chain. And as you've seen in the film, a lot of the material is actually shot in Kano District in Sierra Leone, but we end up at the end of the film in Antwerp talking to some of the people at the very top end of the chain. Many of the issues that we discuss in the film and that we explore are quite challenging and quite controversial. It's always not very easy getting people to open up about sensitive issues, especially things like illicit diamond trading. But one of the things I think that's been really positive is that we have this long relationship working with people in Kano District. As I said, you know, the work I've been doing goes back 15 years. So there's really been these relationships of trust that have built up over time, and I think that's one of the reasons why we were able to get people to talk so openly about some of these very, very difficult and challenging issues.
Yeah, and purely from a filming perspective, I guess, one of the major challenges you face when you film in a country like Sierra Leone is you can't pop out to pick up kit that you may have forgotten or that may have become broken during the filming. So prior to heading out, you have to kind of draw up a contingency for every eventuality. But at the same time, you have to obviously be wary of taking too much gear because you need to be able to stay mobile when you're in the field. Often filming this, it would involve me, Roy, and two local fixers, Felix and Sar. And essentially, we'd be jumping into a 4x4, driving across country, going to a diamond mine, jumping out, we wouldn't have long to film. So you have to be able to remain mobile at the same time. So it's kind of balancing those two demands.
One of the interesting things about the film, I think, is that it's been screened to such a diverse range of people and different audiences. And it's been absolutely fantastic having the opportunity to screen this film to students, to school students in Japan. And we were really pleased to read some of the essays that you've written on the film. We were only sent the ones that were in English, and I know there were many that were obviously written in Japanese. But I think we were both really impressed at the level of engagement with these very important issues in the artisanal diamond value chain. And the passion also that came through. It was very clear that many of you really understood some of these very important issues around labor, around working conditions, around fair pay, and what this actually means for people at the bottom of the value chain. So it was great to see that there was such you know, good engagement with the main issues that we were really wrestling with in the film. And also, I think it shows us that you know, in Japan, people are very aware of a lot of these issues to do with ethical sourcing, to do with ethical trading. And I think it also goes to show that as consumers at the top of the chain, we do have some power in the decision making over the products and the things that we're buying. And there's always a story behind the things that we're buying. So we're very, very pleased that there was such good engagement with some of these really important issues.
So thank you, everybody. And we really hope you enjoy the event.
Thank you.